Of course, the question that looms large whenever there's any discussion of Iran's nuclear program is how close are the Iranians to developing a nuclear weapon? For much more about that, we're joined now in Washington by David Albright. He is the founder and president of the Institute for Science and International Security and is a leading expert on Iran's nuclear program. So I think in the background of all these talks, all of these delegates and diplomats have to be wondering how close is Iran and will these sanctions work?
Well, Iran's been greatly increasing its nuclear capability over the last 2 years. And so and again, we don't think Iran has made a decision to build nuclear weapons. But if they did, and they use their current stockpiles of low-enriched uranium and the number of centrifuges they have installed at their two enrichment sites, then they could break out in as little as break out and have enough weapon-grade uranium for a bomb in as little as 1 to 1.5 months. It could take them longer. Things can go wrong. It would take them longer to build the bomb itself. Estimates vary. I mean, it's a very murky area to make assessments in, and so it could vary from a couple months to up to a year. And it also varies, do they want a crude nuclear explosive device that they could test underground or just possess, or do they want a warhead for a ballistic missile? And the latter would take probably more than a year to accomplish.
Without getting too far into the science or getting into a physics lesson here, there's kind of different gradations of uranium and what happens to it and how it's processed and whether it's for nuclear power or it's for a nuclear weapon, right?
That's right. And so, but the problem is that the same 3.5% enriched uranium produced for a nuclear power reactor can be used to, can be further enriched up to 90%, the enrichment level that you use in a nuclear weapon. So it's the 3.5% enriched uranium is actually quite a ways, 70% of the way to the 90%. This isn't linear, and a lot of the work goes into that first 3.5% enriched uranium. So it's one of the dilemmas of this is there's no clear benchmark or action Iran can take that would provide a guarantee that it wouldn't later use the enriched uranium to further enrich it up to weapon grade.
And then what about the delivery capabilities? That is primarily the reason that so many people in the neighborhood, so to speak, are concerned.
The likelihood is that if Iran was going to break out, if it decided to do that, it would be seeking, at least in my view, probably just a crude nuclear explosive. I mean, that's what North Korea did. That's what other countries have did. South Africa. They just try to get one that isn't that deliverable, certainly not deliverable by missiles. And that they would be looking to just get across the threshold and establish that. It could be through leaking that it has nuclear weapons. It could be conducting a full-scale underground nuclear test. But that would be the priority. So more than likely, they wouldn't need a full year to have a nuclear explosive device that they could test underground or just at least claim they have that they're now a nuclear power.
And how much does that change their negotiating posture or the posture of the world negotiating with them?
Well, if they move to get nuclear weapons, I mean, there's a very good chance that there would be a war. I mean, President Obama has made it clear that he would prevent Iran from getting a nuclear weapon. Israel's threshold for attack is much lower than Iran moving to get a nuclear weapon. So I think if Iran did that, it's going to either have to do it in a way where they're not detected before they succeed, and particularly produce the weapon-grade uranium for a bomb. I mean, that's really the long pole in the tent. Once they have that, they can move it, and it'll be almost impossible to find it. And the options to stop Iran at that point are going to become much more complicated. Before they have the weapon-grade uranium for a bomb, the sites that enrich can be bombed. And you can, if you do it in time, you can stop Iran from succeeding. But Iran may be trying to develop a capability where it could break out and produce enough weapon-grade uranium for a bomb before they're detected. And that's one of the clocks ticking in this negotiations. I mean, our assessment is they could reach that point as soon as mid-2014.
All right. David Albright for the Institute of Science and International Security joining us from Washington. Thanks so much.
Thank you.